Welcome back everyone. So let's get started with insert learning. For that you need to search for insert learning in the Google search box. The first link that appears up is insertlearning.com. This is where we want to go. Let's click on that link and it will direct us to the insertlearning.com webpage. All right. Now here you can see it is giving two options, either to log in or I can add it to Chrome. Now since it is a web tool, so it is available as an add-on or you can say as an extension so that you can use it freely on any web page, whatever things you search on your Google Chrome browser. So let's add it to the Chrome. Now, since I have already added it, you can go to the web store or follow that link to add this web tool to your browser. It will ask you to log in. You can either log in as from a Google account or from a Microsoft account. All right, so I have already logged in. So now it is asking me if I am a teacher or a student. This Insert Learning app is available for both students as well as teachers. So right now we are going to start with the teacher. We will look at the student view later on. So I am a teacher. I will click on teacher and let's see. All right, now it is asking me to name a class. Here you can create a class or you can directly import your class from Google Classroom. So if you want to import your class from Google Classroom, you can click not now button. Or if you want to create a new class here on insertlearning.com, then you can create your class. So let's say we create a class, my class here. And this is not mandatory to create a class. You can import your class already created in Google Classroom. All right. So let's create this class. So this is the dashboard of Insert Learning, which is available here. So the first tab you see here is the lessons. So lessons tab is open and it is giving me a button to create a new lesson, and it is showing some simple steps to create a lesson. Let's create a lesson in three steps, like select any web page, add questions to the page, and send that lesson to your class. All right, we'll look at these tabs later on. First, let's create a lesson. So to create a lesson, I will click on a new lesson. All right, now it is showing two options to create a lesson. The first option it is showing is you can click on the Insert Learning extension. So here is the Insert Learning extension. I have already added it to my Chrome browser. I can use it on any web page and turn it into an interactive web page. All right, so this is the first option, how you can create a lesson. This Insert Learning extension will provide you with a lot of tools on that web page. And another one is to find in the public library or the resources Insert Learning provides on its own platform. So let's visit another web page. So we will go by the first option. We will visit a web page and use this Insert Learning extension to modify our page. So let's say I want to create a lesson on information and communications technology. So let's find out. Let's search for a web page on ICT. So the first link comes up is information and communications technology. This is a Wikipedia page. Now I want to create this page as an interactive one by adding questions, by adding discussion forums, by adding video links, and many more things that I want to according to my students' requirement. So let's do that, and we will continue this in the next video.